This is Constantijn Huygens. It is a self-portrait made in the year 1685. During his life, he often made drawings of his family and friends and places he visited. He also recorded his life in a diary kept from his early 20s until a year before his death. This diary of more than 1500 pages offers a surprising view of life in the Dutch Golden Age. Nearly his whole long life, Constantijn Huygens made daily notes as regular as clockwork. His diary resembles the one kept by his English contemporary Samuel Pepys. Both men wrote candidly about their daily life. They shared interests in art, books and science, and last but not least, sex. Their diaries were private. Just like Pepys, Huygens now and then used a cipher. Constantijn Huygens was born in 1628 and named after his father, who had commissioned this portrait. He is seen in his function of secretary to Frederik Hendrik, Prince of Orange and Stadtholder of the Dutch Republic. He hands over a letter to a servant. On his desk lie pen and paper. We also see a lute, an architectural design, two globes and books, making clear that he was a poet, composer and connoisseur of art. Looking closer, we also see a watch, symbol of his interest in science. A few years later, he was portrayed surrounded by his young children. On top, on the right, his eldest son, Constantijn, the future diarist. On the left, his second son, Christian, a future scientist. The young Constantijn Huygens studied law at the University of Leiden, and in 1672 he was appointed secretary to the new stadtholder, Prince William of Orange. He followed in the footsteps of his father. In his diary, he often wrote about the daily proceedings at the secretarial office. He was constantly busy with letters and documents. Now and then something went wrong, and then we read diary notes like, "This morning, changing clothes, I found in my pocket a letter from the stadtholder to the grand pensionary, which I forgot to mail last Friday, what made me feel sorry and confused me." Younger brother Christian Huygens devoted his life to science. Here he is portrayed with his greatest invention, the pendulum clock. The pendulum made clocks much more reliable. More exact time measurement opened the way for major breakthroughs in astronomy. The modern watch, with a spring, also was invented by Christian Huygens. With Isaac Newton, he laid the foundation for a new time awareness. Time no longer was seen as cyclical, the eternal return of day and night and of the seasons, but as linear, as a continual stream. This old-fashioned father time is turning a wheel. This modern, linear father time holds Christian's pendulum on a painting commissioned by the Huygens family. The regularity of the diary kept by Constantijn Huygens reflects the new concept of time developed by his brother Christian. Constantijn and Christian shared many scientific interests. Together they built microscopes and telescopes. Both learned to grind lenses. They signed and dated their lenses. With his telescope, Christian discovered the ring around Saturn. While Christian Huygens studied the solar system, his brother Constantijn Huygens studied the court of Prince William of Orange. Being his secretary, he had an ideal observation post within this microcosm. Like planets circle around the sun, courtiers circled around the prince. Huygens recorded the various distances of courtiers from the center of this solar system in his diary. Each day, Huygens wrote notes about his fellow courtiers, mainly gossip. Behind courtly manners, another world was hidden. Huygens was especially interested in their sex lives. Who had fathered bastard children? Who kept which mistress? What did they exactly do in bed? Who got which venereal disease? And from whom? Huygens recorded it all in his diary in the smallest details. Sex was an important subject of conversation at court. On October 27, 1682, Huygens wrote that he had leafed through a pornographic booklet with some other courtiers. He concluded that the illustrations were made by Romein de Hoge. He was probably right. In his library, this book is found, illustrated by this prolific engraver. Another reoccurring theme in the diary is warfare. During the war between the Dutch Republic and France after 1672, Huygens participated every summer in military campaigns. After the peace of 1678, a more tranquil decade followed. Then suddenly, a new military operation was about to start. On the 21st of October 1688, Huygens wrote in his diary that a commander in the Dutch army had said to him, "We will start a great and glorious enterprise." Huygens was at that moment on the Dutch fleet, ready to sail to England. In the weeks that followed, he recorded from day to day the course of what historians later called the Glorious Revolution. After a large-scale invasion of England, Prince William of Orange and his wife, Mary Stuart, took over the English throne from the deposed King James. The next year, Huygens was in Ireland, where he was an eyewitness of the Battle of the Boyne, in which James was beaten. This battle was depicted by the Dutch painter Dirk Maas, who was hired by King William as embedded artist. Huygens's best friend at court, William Bentinck, Earl of Portland, commissioned from Dirk Maas another version, with himself and the king in the center. Huygens discussed this painting with Bentinck, as he noted in his diary, and somewhere on the site, Maas had painted Huygens. During the 9 years' war that followed, King William fought Louis XIV of France every summer in the southern Netherlands. Huygens kept a daily record of these campaigns. To him, these summer months were a kind of vacation. He enjoyed looking at the bustling Indian encampments, where settlers sold their wares, scenes that he has often drawn. He also recorded the consequences of the battles, the dead bodies and the horses along the way. A day after the French bombardment of Brussels, he entered the city. Although used to the miseries of war, he was shocked to see what he called horrible ruins. Huygens had been an eyewitness of a new development in warfare, a large-scale bombardment of a civilian target with the only intention to create terror. After the Glorious Revolution, Huygens lived mainly in London. He spoke English fluently, although with a Dutch accent, probably. In London, he had time for reading. He had a large library with more than 5,000 books. In the sale catalogue, compiled after his death, we can see what he read. No religious literature, but Spinoza. His works are mentioned in a special section, Forbidden Books. Here we also find a book by Hadrianus van Beverland, a Dutch scholar who had identified the original sin with the first sexual act. For that reason, van Beverland was banned from Holland and lived in exile in London. Huygens describes in his diary several encounters with this free spirit and libertine, here portrayed with his mistress. Huygens writes often about the bookshops he visited. Sometimes authors asked him to be introduced to King William, like the French explorer Louis Hennepin, who succeeded in gaining royal support for publishing his travel account in America. Constantijn Huygens was an enthusiast collector of paintings and drawings. His taste was the taste at court, the great Italians, Da Vinci, Michelangelo and above all Raphael. He showed no interest in Dutch masters like Jan Steen or Frans Hals, as they painted for the bourgeoisie. As a young man, Huygens had made a grand tour to France and Italy. Thereafter, he had developed into a connoisseur, whose judgments on authenticity and artistic value were held in high regard. King William asked him often advice in art matters. In London, Huygens became a kind of museum director, in charge of the hanging of paintings in the new gallery at Kensington Palace. Huygens knew many painters personally, like Godfrey Kneller. The king asked Huygens to be present when he was sitting for this portrait. Huygens had built an important collection of Italian drawings and prints. On the 2nd of March 1690, he made a note in his diary that the widow of a Flemish painter offered him for sale some 100 drawings by Leonardo da Vinci. He did not hesitate, and it was a high point in his collection. After his death, these drawings disappeared, only to surface in the 20th century. Today they are identified as 16th century copies of original da Vinci drawings that are now lost. In London, Huygens had his portrait made by a French ivory carver, Jean Cavalier. Another customer of Cavalier was Samuel Pepys. The resemblance between the two men is striking. They must have met in London, because they went to the same bookshops, the same clockmakers, and had many acquaintances in common. They were both involved in the Royal Society of London for improving natural knowledge. Huygens often wrote in his diary about his wife Susanna and his son, a student at the University of Leiden. Huygens had to reprimand his son frequently for his laziness and misdemeanors, especially during student dinners. In his diary, he wrote that this made him melancholic. During the winters in London, he missed his wife. He confessed more than once that he longed to return to Holland. He wanted to retire on the family country house Hofwijk, here seen in a drawing by himself. He was not the only Dutchman in London plagued by homesickness. Even King William confessed to Huygens that he missed Holland. Huygens recorded in his diary that the king once said to him, "I would give 100,000 guilders to be able to fly to The Hague." That was now totally unthinkable. His brother Christian had already designed a combustion engine for a flying machine. In 1695, Christian Huygens died. His brother prepared his last book for publication. The book was dedicated to him. A year later, the king gave him a pension. Huygens went to live on his country estate Hofwijk. Here he is depicted in the garden. Did he contemplate writing his memoirs based on his diary? The genre was becoming popular. The Count of Grammont had in his often reprinted memoirs sketched a portrait of Huygens' father. People he knew personally did publish their memoirs, like Conrad Droste and Madame Soutelande, both mentioned in his diary. Huygens did not have the time, however, and a year later he died. His diary survived. His books were sold in auction. What happened to his drawings, prints and paintings is not known. But we know from the diary what he regarded the high point of his collection. This painting by Antonie van Dijk. We see Saturn depicted as Father Time, cutting the wings of Amor. It is inspired by this emblem. The message is, love resists time. In the same way, his diary has resisted time. After 3 centuries, his diary allows us to enter his world, bringing us back to the 17th century both in England and in the Netherlands.